Hello, welcome to the channel. It's amazing to see the progress that the RPCS3 team has made recently. After a period without major updates since Christmas 2022, they have surprised us with significant improvements. Now, not only can we enjoy games like Gran Turismo 5 and Gran Turismo 6, but we have also witnessed various optimizations that benefit especially those who have more basic GPUs. If you're passionate about emulation and love staying up to date with the latest news, don't forget to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to follow our weekly videos.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
If you have an older GPU and had issues with RPCS3, you can expect better performance now. Starting from version 0.2815302, the emulator received an optimization that benefits especially those who don't have GPUs with GDDR6X memory. Additionally, the new versions also bring various optimizations for games like GT5 and GT6. It's important to note that these games are still not fully optimized and are in the in-game state. I conducted comparative tests between the two versions, and even with my GPU using GDDR6X memory, I noticed significant gains in GT6. However, the audio issue still hasn't been resolved in GT5. Let's start our tests with Gran Turismo 5. It seems that the previous version had better performance than the new versions. At the end of the analysis, I achieved an average of 46 FPS in version 15277, while in version 15307, it was 41 FPS. However, the 1% low showed a significant improvement, going from 9 FPS in version 15277 to 26 FPS in version 15307. This indicates that, even without a noticeable increase in the frame rate, the new version has fewer stuttering issues, providing a smoother experience in GT5. In the case of Gran Turismo 6, I also observed a significant gain. Although the average FPS remained stable during the test due to some specific conditions, most data points showed an increase of 2 to 6 FPS. Additionally, the 1% low went from 21 FPS in version 15277 to 25 FPS in version 15307. In God of War 3, I also monitored the average and maximum FPS, and as you can see, the average was practically the same. Even with a large enemy on the screen and multiple effects happening simultaneously, the game remained stable, with an average above 40 FPS. We can consider it a technical tie in God of War 3. In Skate 3, we had a completely different result. The maximum FPS in version 15277 reached 233, while in version 15307, it was only 152 FPS. The 1% low remained at 72 FPS in both tests. These differences are easily noticeable, and so far, the biggest changes have been observed in the Gran Turismo series. In the last game tested, Sonic Unleashed, it is still in the unplayable state, with many stutters, and it is necessary to disable some graphical options, such as dynamic shadows, to achieve better performance. In this case, we also noticed a worse performance in version 15307. That concludes our short video. Test these versions on your GPUs and share in the comments if you have seen better results than before. In my preliminary tests, I was only able to observe improvements in Gran Turismo. I know many of you will ask me about Red Dead Redemption and when the new comparison between RPCS3 and Xenia will be released. I am already working on both videos, but especially the RPCS3 vs Xenia is a complex project that requires downloading several gigabytes of games, so I ask for a little patience. Thank you to everyone who watched until the end, and we'll see you in the next video.